this poem, or through this poem, what we learned is how to decide, how to determine, right? And what is a conviction, and how an interest plays in your life. These are all things we have learned, and how important is your interest. I don't call this convictions and determinations and decisions, I don't call. The interest, what you see, what you follow, by what you want to guide yourself, that is your interest. How that helps you? Hope, again. If I am a failure here, my entire life had come down scattered, let me end off my life. No. There is a purpose for your living. There is a purpose for your existence. There is a purpose for your birth. Maybe here you have got your failures. Maybe it is not your failure. You look at it as a failure. Then take a hope once again. Take a change through the hope. See that what guidelines over there. Be guided with that. You can fulfill. That is what we learned through this poem. Now, a vocational education under D. What is this vocational education? To be able to read and write. Yeah, I know how to read. Yeah, I know how to write. Is this sufficient for a man to enter into the society? No. Then there are certain skills you have to take up. Then you can have your stand in the society. Right? So, I myself has taken up a teacher's path and I started my career as a teacher. And one of my friend who did not even complete his 10th class, he has taken up a plumbing job. My friend who has taken up a plumbing job, he wanted me to come into his trade. I said, no, it is a failure. What a plumbing job, to connect two pipes. Any person could do it. And so I did not go there. I remained as a teacher. Right? And that fellow, very recently I could find him, he is having about 10 people working under him. So as a plumber, he has his own office. As a teacher, I don't have my own office. I am going to the office. And I don't have 10 teachers under me, working under me. No, I am only the teacher. And he is a plumber. He has 10 plumbers working under him. What is the difference? I am literate. I am not educated. Do you mean he is not educated? He is educated in his own line. I should not compare myself with that, because he is vocationally trained. He got his own education and I got my own education. And now, because he has 10 people working under him, I cannot switch over there. I should hope a good thing now here. As a teacher, let me be a successful teacher. Let me not cross over to that path. No. Likewise, after completion of SSC, you will be having many openings. And here I have written certain things. These are vocational. Means you are trained to do that so that you can stand in the society with a status. You are called as a tailor. Earlier, if you see the caste system during our Vedic period, the caste system is based on that only, vocational only. Because the potter who makes the pots, it is a vocation, I cannot do it. He does a very good round shaped pot, he can do it. And he knows where to cut it. And where the shaping is necessary. And if they see the mouth, it is perfect round. He doesn't use a compass there. Right? Simply by the placement of his fingers, he can make small circles. He may make big circles, wider circles even. So earlier potters, washermen, right, and hairdressers, right, and not only these, some other services were very essential earlier, that is palanquin bearers, because they know their skill, where to stop and where, how to carry and how not to feel the load and all these things, they know it. It is a skillful job only, it is a vocational job, palanquin bearer even, right? And again, they make the garlands, flower girls, as Sarojini Naidu said, right? And even the band, the music and all these things, which are very essential in our many of the auspicious occasions, and the band party, the musicians, they have their own art. Dancers to please people, right? And drama, people playing the drama, theater. These were thought to be vocational education earlier. Now, as a change there, because the change is inevitable, when it is inevitable, when the society is getting changed, the needs of the society also get changed. And then when the needs are getting changed, your vocation also getting changed. You have to adapt yours to that change. Now, people have never dreamt about a beautician is necessary for us. Now, it has become a prominent trade in the society. If you walk from here to that Balkampet area, you may at least find a dozen of beautician salons over there. Why? People are becoming more beauty conscious. And that they feel that is one of the characteristics to determine your personality. So that has become a vocation now. Now if you see tailor, it is there since long. Only one caste of people used to take care. Now many people are there in that. What is it called again? Here tailoring means designing. Wardrobe designer. You see how the names are getting changed, right? But the origin is that only, tailor. And if you see plumber, earlier it is only a connection. Earlier to that, people used to go to well and draw water and bring home. There are no pipes carrying water from that to your house. So plumber was not at all existed. Now it is a daily routine. If you get your sink repaired today, and tomorrow you can see in your bathroom, the shower is not working. So it is a daily need for you to have a plumber. Typist. For about 2 to 3 decades after independence, typing was considered as very main important vocational training. Why? Everywhere that is applicable. Now also one who learned typing, he is having a very good scope working with the computers now. It is there everywhere. It is an essential one and it is being followed. And now we have a very small understanding about our vocational education. So after having that kind of understanding and as per the needs of the society, the vocationals are getting changed. See to it what I am talking. Right? Yesterday he was called as an engineer, electrical engineer. Right? But he designs the concealed electrical connections. Or many things they can do it along with the designing of the house. Right? So he is becoming a designer, house completely, interior decorator, many things are there. Here I want a light, there I don't want a false one, and here I want this one. So he works along with other professionals there. So parallel lines are being drawn between the vocation to vocation. So here you can see at D1 what we have is this is a Rohan. He is not interested in the usual set of professional courses like the ones mentioned above. Do you think he can try his hand at something else, work in pace and try to find the courses that may like from the word maze given below. Here is the maze. It has many letters here. If you combine the letters either vertically or crossword, we will be getting certain vocational names. If you see in the beginning, in the first vertical one, electrician is there. In the second, after leaving three letters from M, if you see, machinist, right? And again, if you see the third one, leaving six letters or five letters, welder, right? And again, if you see here, in the fourth one, after leaving P, first one, the other letters you can see, foundry man. What is a foundry man? What is here your welder and what is your machinist and what is electrician? These are all trades. Earlier there used to be ITI, Industrial Training Institute. After 10th class, you can join over there and take one of the trades there. Welder trade, electrician trade. Likewise, your foundry man. Foundry means your metals are to be heated and they are to be what we can say is to be melted. And this melted material should be poured into the molds to form their shapes. And after that, they are to be machined. Machinists do that. When you are melting and putting that melted material in your molds, they get a shape, but that is a rough shape. And the foundry man does that, putting that molded material into that molds. He is called a foundry man. And machinist, whatever is not necessary, that will be cut, removed, and brushed, or your ground and all these things he does. He is the machinist. These two are interlinked. And again, your librarian. In every school, in every college, there is a librarian. There is a librarian. There he should have his own skills. Not that everybody does it. Why? The books are to be maintained. By sitting there on the table itself, you should know where is a certain book is placed. You should know it. Means what? You are a very good librarian. You have your science. How best you are maintaining your library. Then you have beautician here again. And after that you have a retailer. Retailer. People say it is the job of a baniya. Baniya pahle karta tha. Magar now the retailing is different now. Earlier whatever the baniya says, people used to pay and take it. Even he used to sell a soap cake of MRP, 7 rupees, he used to sell it for 10 rupees and 12 rupees according to the customer. It is not that now the retailing has changed face now. So you should know the ins and outs of the retailing. Understood? So that is a course now, retailing, how best you can do it. Right? And a person doing this retailing job, he is the supply officer or the manager supply chain in a company. He knows how much of what goods have to be sent to which place. That is retailing. Right? And now after that we have many other, that is again tailoring we have. Beautician, tailoring, retailing, right? Retailer, right? Likewise we have many jobs here. Typist also we have here. Right? And insurance advisor, these are all insurance advisor. Earlier insurance fellow means people used to go away from him, escape from him. Now insurance has become a very essential part in everybody's life. So how best you are selling your insurance policy, how you are recommending a certain policy to a certain person. Again, every policy is not given to every person, not like that. Seeing the capacity of the man, age of the man, and again his job, he advises you to take up some policy. That way insurance is also one of the vocational training. So if you see all these things, you will be taking up some job. This maze, word maze, has that one crossword puzzle, we say, we have these vocational trainings here. And what is that vocational training? Why it is essential? Why it is important? That we are going to learn here under this, what we call as a table has been given. You have to match them. So then you will be having a clear understanding. What are the maze contained about the vocational training? Here, those have been put over here under jobs A. Fitter, machinist, foundry man, electrician, welder, typist, retailer. Almost everything I have put over here. Fitter means he simply fits which part of your vehicle attached to which part and which nut and bolt have to be put and fix it. That is only the fitter's job. He doesn't do machining, he doesn't do grinding, he doesn't do any cutting, nothing. Everything has been put and that you fix and put a bolt and fit it, that is fitter's job. Electrician, you know, it is a day in, day out job, and so you know it. Welder, he welds two things, metallic things. Brass welding is there and steel welding is there, stainless steel welding is there and mild steel welding is there. Everything according to the metal, the welding differs. But welding is his job. How nicely he can do it means you will not be knowing whether it is welded or not. That way they can do it. It is a very skillful job again. Publisher. So he collects many writers and he does, I want this kind of a thing to be written. And he takes that, examines it and he publishes. Because he should know who is a good writer and he should know who is a good reader. And he is the linkage between these two. He publishes and sells. Right? And again, insurance service provider, I told you already. Plumber, I need not tell you already, you know it and I have explained. Designer, tailoring designer. Designer, interior decorator also, a designer. And architect, he is also a designer. And your tailor, also a designer. And beautician, I told you, what is the importance? According to the occasion, he can make you up. And librarian, tailor, sheet metal worker, he was called as a tinsmith earlier. And earlier to your this suitcases, etc., your travel mates, American traveler, tourister, many things have come with the bags and the jeeps and etc. Earlier it was not there. Why earlier? About 3 decades it was not there. Then you had only a trunk, which is called a trunk. And it has all the hinges and all these things. But tin metal is folded, no welding there. It has been folded to have the shape of a box. And even it used to have this, what we can, shelves in it. Everything is made. And it is made in such a manner, if you are carrying it or if you are handling it, you should not be having scratches in your skin. Very smooth finish they used to give with a tin smith. And you must have seen this curious in tins, oil tins. Now many things have, plastic has replaced that again there. So these sheet metal workers, they used to work, your almirahs are there. Almirahs, of course, not wooden ones, the tin ones. They are folded in such a manner. They are taken such kind of an angle. What angle has to be given to give this shape? That is tin sheet metal worker. And sericulturist, where you have this fruits, right? Horticulturist, where you have these flowers. Florist means one who makes the garlands. And horticulture, where you are having growing the flowers, etc. Sericulture, where you are growing the fruit, etc. These are all the vocational subjects you are getting trained over there, because the society needs now, presently, the society needs that. So vocational education under D3, what are the definition is given? We have seen these tables, etc. We understood it. We have matched it already. And we have seen the maze, word maze. From that also we have known certain things. And there is other picture where a boy sits and thinks about which line he has to take. Right? Now, what is vocational education? Vocational education prepares learners for jobs that are based on manual or practical activities. Manual and practical, typist. It is a practice without seeing the text, without seeing, looking at what is being typed over there. People are typing pages together. Tuck, 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 it goes. It depends on the practice, how best you can do. Right? And it was traditionally considered non-academic. It is has no connection with academics. No, it is traditionally thought about. But it has a linkage with the academics. Right? A plumber who simply got education up to 8th class. A plumber having no education. There will be a difference. A plumber after 10th class. Right? Means it has a linkage with the education, literacy also. But traditionally thought, there is no linkage. If at all you are good at that, it is okay. But if I am a typist, if I don't know English, then my work may contain many mistakes. And whatever is there, simply I will be copying. And I don't bother whether it is L or T, whether the writer did not put a bar over there. I don't bother because I am illiterate. No, it has a connection with the literacy also. So, and totally related to a specific trade, occupation or vocation. Hence, it is sometimes referred as technical education. It is generally given at the secondary and post-secondary levels. During when you are in school, you are learning computers. Why computers? Computers and operation of that, it is vocational. Right? And post-secondary, after that also you have ITI. You can join over there. And you can have your own trade, either fitter or welder or machinist or metal sheet worker. All these things, they have many wings over there. Or a draftsman. Right? That way you can take up. Level. It focuses on development of skills that are needed for specific trades, and hence practical work is given greater importance than bookish learning. Bookish learning will be small, little, but your practical will be more. You will be going on drawing, you are going on drawing, unless you get perfection over there. If you want to be a commercial artist. Right? And now, there is an urgent need to respond to the growing skill requirements so that the momentum of the economy can be sustained. Economy, it is running fast. And then the change in skills should also take the pace. They have to go along with that economy, how it is running. Why? Many of the services are cheaper here in India than abroad. People who come visiting to India to see places, they are doing two things. They want to see the places and they wanted to get those services which are cheaper there. And so you can see people coming from abroad for sightseeing, they must be having long hair. They continue to be here watching all the places with long hair. But when they go back, about to go back, they do have a service of hair cutting. They must carry all the sore clothes from there, worn out clothes. But while they go from here, they get themselves washed here itself because washing services here, what we can say, cheaper. So the services industry, knowingly or unknowingly, they are in exporting it, right? So people are coming here, and according to that needs of the economy, we have to change our services, and so our trade and our vocational and everything, people have to be trained in that line. By focusing on the employability, our education system can fulfill the requirements of skilled manpower. Further, vocational education also creates more employment opportunities by equipping learners with entrepreneurial skills. It also addresses the changing face of technology through diversified courses. Technology required many people, manpower, skilled manpower. Because if I am running a company, I don't want to take them and train to my requirements. That means what? I'll have to pay to them, and also I'll have to pay to the training people. Then if I get a set of people who are already trained, then one of the expenditure I am cutting short. So that way people should be ready with the trained skills in certain trades, in certain jobs. However, there are many concerns, foremost among them being low motivation among the students to pursue vocational education. It is compounded by the rigid mindset of parents and educators in accepting vocational courses. It is also a painful fact that many vocational courses that are being offered have become obsolete, since there is a poor linkage between institutions offering vocational courses and the private sector. Students often find it difficult to secure proper employment immediately after completing their courses. Suppose a welder is there. A welder. Food industry, if he seeks job, does a welder get it? No. He should go to an engineering industry where welding is a must. He should go to such an industry, whether it is heavy or middle or low, where engineering work is being taken. And simply, I was a welder, I did not get a job. That way you should not think. You are not catering to the needs, mismatching again. So with the thought of that, developing people in certain courses. And now, what are the courses required? You can see the journalism. The journalism, radio jockey, RJ, DJs. Never, people never thought about it. This kind of job may also be there. This is a skill where I can sell myself. People are not knowing. That kind of skills were coming up. Right? Cobbler was a skill yesteryears. Now, how many cobblers do you find on the road? No. Why? People knew pretty well. If my this slipper, it is torn, means throw it, take new one. It is cheaper than to go to a cobbler. Right? Likewise, carpentry, carpenter. They have changed into regular carpentry to interior decorators. They go for that kind of furniture because much of money is there. Likewise, you have to match yourself in the running need of the society. Not that people are ready to take you with your skills. No, you have to change your skills. So there was a mismatch between the two things. That is, where the want is there and where the supply is there. Right? Suppose in certain area, there where typists are not necessary, and in the institutions in that area, many people are coming out from the typing skills. Then he has to go somewhere else, wherever the need is there. Journalism is same thing. You have to go where the news is getting created. Not that you have to create the news. Now the journalism will depend on the thing, how best I can create a news. No, go there where the news is getting created by itself, then you take up how best you are presenting, that is journalism. News getting created, but how best you are presenting it to the people, that is where journalist comes. So there are many skills according to the changing and modern society. As a result, since there is a poor linkage between the institutions offering vocational courses and the private sector. Private sector people, they need many people, many kinds of people. If a welder goes to a TV channel, "Sir, I'm a welder, sir. Can I get a chance in your organization, sir?" That fellow has to say, "Sorry, I don't want a metal welder here. I want a welder where he can connect the incident and the people. I want him only." So a welder should seek a job where his requirement is there. That is a mismatching. People are just thinking the vocational training is useless. No, it is very much useful. Students often find it difficult to secure proper employment. Proper means what? You get yourself proper over there, you get a proper employment opportunities there. And you may get a very good package of salary. You may be a welder alone, but you seek, you put your all the skills in such a manner, you may be taken and you may be given a very good package of salary. You are thinking proper means good package of salary. You show your skills in such a manner. So as a result of globalization, new sectors of both manufacturing and service industries. What is manufacturing industry? Where a new goods are being produced. What is service industry? Where you are putting your services. You can open your own shop and you can say the best welding is being done here and bring your jobs here, I can supply. That is your service. Right? And typing. Where to find out a typing job? It is where the quotes are there. Wherever quotes are there, if I open my shop over there, I'll get enough money over there, enough opportunity to serve over there. Not that I will be just a typist, sir. Do you have a vacancy for a typist, sir? So that is a trend. The trend has to be changed. You put your services for the sale. Let people come to you. Not that you are going on door to door to sell your services. No, don't do that. You open your own shop. That is the thing. As a result of globalization, new sectors in both manufacturing and service industries have opened up. A dry cleaner is there. What is a dry cleaning? It is a shop he opened there. Earlier, the washerman used to come to your door. See the change of services. Earlier, hairdresser used to come to your door. Weekly once. "Sir, are you ready, sir?" Now, you are going to a salon now to the hairdresser. That is a change completely. Setup of society is getting changed. So, you should be ready with your services. Where to sell it? You have to decide it. Let people come and purchase from you. Take it from you. Rather, what you are doing is, you are going to door to sell it. Don't do that. Nowadays, door to door selling is completely stopped. Make known that you are this. Let people come to you. So, service industries have opened up. Hospitality, fashion technology, film and television, information technology, retail, healthcare, etc. are some of the emerging areas that require skilled manpower. Now when it is put over here, healthcare earlier also used to call your doctor at home, or you are going up and queuing up in a somewhat medical practitioner. But now you can browse in your networking. My ailment is this. Let me call the doctor. Simply you have to put your requirement and address. There will be a call and a doctor will be there. So you see the services, how they are changing. Earlier you are going to the Apollo hospital or something like that. Now you need not to visit for your diagnosis some doctor. Not necessary, he will come to your house, he will diagnose and he will prescribe such and such medicines or such and such surgery somewhere in some hospital. That way your services are coming to the doorsteps in such way. And you have already have a shop, and the shop made known to everybody. That way you are present here for the services, right? So here we have again what we understood under D4 and D5, something else we are going to read. D4 is what we understood about vocational education. Preparation related to what? And you are generally at the disposal of somebody. That is what we have known. And D4, after reading this, we have to fill it up. 2.3 is creates. 2.4 addresses and concerns. 3, low, rigid, obsolete, poor linkage. You see, no skill is obsolete. If you know how to make pots, earlier the pots are used for cooking and all these things, storage and all these things. Now plastic has come and there is a wide change in that. Means pottery died or what? It has become obsolete. Obsolete means something which has died. Right? So is it dead? Pottery? No. Now pottery they are making and they are putting designs and it has become a part of interior designing, interior decoration. Now that way they are making it. And people are not entirely depending on that. I have the skills of making pots and putting designs on it. Right? And I did not take it as an entirely my living. No. Some other thing I am taking up again. So it is there. Obsolete cannot be. Typing. Now no type machines. Hardly there are any. Then computer typing. The typist is existed. The skill is existing still, right? And he is typing and printing. He is doing that. So none of the thing is low or high or rigid, because it is to be changeable. No vocational subject to be taken as a rigid one. It is flexible. And now likewise we have to put all these things here after understanding what we, and after having an understanding what we have understood about this, we have to put over here. And now D5. Based on the information provided in the section along with the input given below, write an article on the growing need of vocational education. Education curriculum requires fresh perspective, fresh understanding. What is vocational? People should understand about it. Why you are B.Tech? What is B.Tech? Mechanical. You are very proudly you are telling, no? B.Tech mechanical means what? High-cadered fitter he is. High-cadered machinist he is. Mechanical engineer. Right? And in that mechanical also, there are many things again. Pneumatics, hydrostatic, and many things are there again. Right? And here, electrician, electrical engineer. Electronics engineer, information and technological engineer. We call them as engineer because he is spending more money in that and he is reading that. And in ITI we have electrician, right? He has to connect two things. So likewise, a bigger engineer and a smaller engineer, that's all. But you have to learn it. Again, diploma holders we have. Some other thing. Skill is same. And if at all you are developing that skills in there, you are you. You are using your vocational training in a very good manner. So now we are reading about something else. In India, every year 650,000 engineers and engineering graduates and approximately 2 million graduates pass out of colleges. Nearly two-thirds of these 6.5 lakhs engineering graduates need to be reskilled so that they can get jobs in the industry. After getting passed, whether it is campus interview or whatsoever, they are not directly recruited. You are kept on probation. What is probation period? And depends on the you are showing your skills. It may be for 1 year, it may be for 6 months, it can be for 18 months, it can be for 2 years, and after completion of 3 months of your probation, you may be asked, Baba, you go. What is this? Again, you got some vocational education over there as a mechanical engineer, but I want a certain person doing this job here. You use whatever you learned over there and study here and get skilled over here and fit yourself into the job which I have shown. If you fail, I am removing you. And if you are showing a normal progress, and I am extending your probation up to 2 years. Thereafter, I don't want you. You may be chalked out. So that way, probation is a training in your industry, in the company itself. So these 6.5 lakhs who are passing through different institutions, they are subjected to get this kind of probation there, so that they can get jobs in the industry. The developed world requires knowledge, workers and skilled professionals. I don't want just pass outs. They should be professionals in their subject. By 2020, only 3 years left to reach the 2020, the developed world will have a shortage of 40 million working people, says a report. A report says 40 millions of people are required, skilled workers required. Though we are producing every year 6.5 lakhs of engineers we are producing, but by 2020 we may have shortage of 40 millions of the skilled workers. According to a survey, 72% of our population is under the age of 35, and it is estimated that 300 million people between the age of 18 and 50 seek employment of some form. Now, what is the statistics shows? Between the age group of 18 to 50, people are regularly seeking for job. Seeking for some job or other. It is a regular statistics taken. And 72% of the population, they are the under age of 35. And 300 millions of people are regularly seeking for the job. So now, earlier it was minimum age limit or maximum age limit. These were there for the government jobs even. Now it has been raised, and now it is 30. Why? After 35 only man is thinking to seek a job. That is the statistics now. And there are people from 18 to 50, they are seeking jobs. Right? While 57% are unemployable, 46% are registered with employment exchanges, with little hope of finding work because there is a mismatch between the skilled manpower required and skilled manpower available. A majority of the youth passing out the colleges do not have the specific skills required by various sectors in the market. Market has various openings, but I am not getting fit into that. Why? I have come out from the college hoping that I am become first class and I may be hired by the company as an accountant. But in a company, accountant means CA. We want CAA intermediate or CA entrance pass. And I am become. No. Did you go for CA entrance? No. You are not qualified. So that way they are choosy. Why choosy they are? They are getting people of that kind. And they found that kind of people are more prosperous than simple BCom. Right? Or do you have the computer training? Do you have that focus training? Some software, many companies are producing their software. Right? Tally. Are you tally literate? They are questioning. If I don't have the tally, I am not qualified. Why? You are to be taken as only the data entry operator in that category of accountancy. And while you are doing the data also, you should know where to enter the credits, where to enter the debits. Right? And so they are taking. And now become computers. That is also one of the vocational subjects has come into regular academics. There are variety. And so if there is a mismatch between the people at hand and the skills which are required and vacancies for which vacancies are there, if there is a mismatch, unemployment will be there. And they are registering under employment exchanges so that there can be a matchup. There are many private people also working as agents. Yes, I have these vacancies. You have this. Okay, I am sending there. Find out. That way there are private employment exchanges also there. You may follow the CODA to write your article. You may arrange your information as suggested below. Para 1, Introduction, the present education system, vocational education, how different. Para 2, the shortcomings of the system, its effect on the development of the country. Para 3, reasons of this mismatch in the market. Para 4, suggestion to bridge the gap. That way you can use the coders and you can put. What for? People should understand. Here in this college, welder trading, these many people have taken up. Why they are taking? And what is the requirement of welder job? And again, this job and how many vacancies are there? Intake of the industry. That way you have to arrange a system of information so that you can open up with new trades in your own institution. And you can train up. And now D6, your school is planning to close down some vocational subjects. According to the statistics taken, welders people don't want. Fitter people don't want. And why I should run it then? Carpentry, it is one of the vocational subject. But people don't want it. Why? There is again mismatch. I have already produced many people. They are lying vacant. They are not taking up that job. They are getting absorbed in some other jobs. So why I should train people in that? So I want to close up with two vocational subjects. But again, students, they may come up. No, it is not like that. Your survey is wrong. We have surveyed it. It is much needed. But these people, they could not sell themselves up. And we want that vocational subject and merits and demerits of that vocational subject. And you want it to be reconsidered once again. Then you have to have group leader, group discussion. What is the coming up out of the discussion? You have to put before the management of the school and you have to recommend it. No, this subject should not be closed. It should be open. That way you have to do under that. And D7, most children face dilemma while choosing the right stream at +2 level. Most of them are unsure of what they want to do. The decision is taken based on popular choices, parents' pressure and peer pressure. Now, children, they are never given the choice of their getting educated in which stream. Either they follow the parents, or they follow the teacher, or some other mentor or peer or somebody, he will say, no, 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 don't go that. You take up this, this has money, you go this. But inherently the child has some interest within him to go for a photography. People never consider photography as a profession. People never consider journalism as a profession. People never take the artist as a profession. If somebody wants to go there, there will be a great objection put by the people, parents' side, mentor's side, peer's side, teacher's side. What photography? You are a girl. How can you go for a photography? And very recently I am seeing in a newspaper, what is that one? Girls taking up the photography. And why so far photography? Why you in yesteryears also we are having some from a person from Hassan family. She is a lady, but she has taken up photography. Sometimes she takes up this action, but sometimes all the her profession is photography. So most of the televisions are there. Most of the people are gathering news, and photography is a must over there. Whether it is a woman candidate or a man candidate, how best you are taking up the stills, how best you are taking the video coverage, how much you are giving, that depends. It simply is acumen, how best you think, which angle, that is given in the training. Whether it is a woman candidate or a man candidate, whatsoever, you are to cope up with that skill, then you are a skillful photographer. So here it is the thing. Rashmi is a student of class 10th. Her school organizes workshop career counseling. It was an eye-opener as she came to know about the possibility of doing a vocational course and learn things that she has always been interested in. And at the same time, she also learned about the requirement of the job market. She has taken a decision about pursuing photography and choreography. Choreography and photography, these two are also professional education, vocational education, much needed for the fast growing society now. And so why people should not go into that area? We have to. But resistance, what resistance she has to face, father, mother and her sister, right? Mother, she is a bit adjustable. Okay, daughter wants to it, let her do it, right? Father, photography for you as a girl, no, I don't recommend. He is the first obstacle over there. And her sister, he is educational counselor. She knows ins and outs of the profession and also the barriers there, limitations over there. And accordingly, who advises how? You have to choreograph this situation and you have to present it. And again, I say choreographing. As a father, what all his thoughts about the career of his daughter, how to prevent it, how to stop her from doing so. Mother, though I am agreeing with my daughter's sayings, what is my mentality and how I put my words, how put my body language over there. To control the body language is called choreography. Where to sit, where to stand, where to put my hand like this, like that, and all these things is the choreography. He directs it. She directs it, right? So here you are being given a skill of choreography about selection of the girl's profession and resistance from the father, mother and sister and all these things. You have to choreograph it, right? And now you have to put up a notice. Notice writing is entirely different. Choreography we have learned here. And how best you are putting the moments, how you are guiding them as a choreographer. The father, how you are guiding. The mother and herself, the chooser of her own vocational subject. right? These are all you are choreographing. You are here, your father is here, your mother is here. She reacts like this, your father reacts like this, and your reaction should be like this. That is what you are controlling. You are the choreographer. Now you are putting up a notice. What are the ingredients required for the notice? You should know it. Date, time, information, and who are you giving the information? These are the things required for a notice. From where? What is the organization? Of course, every organization has its own letterhead. But even if it is not there, if at all you have to write, you have to write the organization's name at the top. And you have to notify it is a notice. Notice to whom? Those who are all concerned with it. And next, what you are writing, the date. When you said it is a notice, and a notification date should be there when you are notifying. Suppose I need a typist. I put a date, right? Today's date is, say, it is, what is the date here? It is, yeah, 5th, 5th of October. Here I put 2015. Do you mean to say if I put this notice, people turn up? No. Why? It is a past one, a 1 year past thing. People may not take it. And so date is very important. You have to put up. Right? And then to whom you are addressing? All those students, all the typists having skills. Right? To him I am putting. And then what is the thing? Here it is a counseling workshop for students of class 9th and 10th that we have to put. What is the notice about? And then what is the date? Day, Saturday, 6th January. Time, between such and such time. Premises, school. Right? That way, day, time and premises is required. School auditorium, venue, premise. And who is the faculty over there? Renowned counselor from MS University. Who is doing that? Right? Personality. What he wanted to do? He wanted to address the students. Students interested in participating should be seated in the auditorium before this hour. That is a notice. And if it is a paid one, you have to write over there. And entrance fee is this much. And you pay it beforehand, before such and such. Book your seat before such and such. How to get the entry into? You can pay through e-payment, or you can pay through banks, or you may pay at the entrance window. That way you have to put it. If it is fee paying, then you have to put this one. If it is free, you have to put it free. Allowed everybody, who the students, all students, class 9th and 10th. That way you have to put. And who you are? You are putting your name and you are putting your status also there. That is the notice. Because it is a school, you are putting in the school. Because it is somewhere else, the company, there also you have to put on the company notice board with this only ingredients there. So what we have seen here is a notice writing and also a choreography we have seen on the vocational subjects. Now we will see about some other thing, the training which a father gives to the child.
If you like this video, please give a thumbs up. Please subscribe to our channel to get more videos on CBSE syllabus.